Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on cosets in group theory of discrete mathematics course. In this video, we have to discuss about what is coset, what are the two types of cosets, what are the properties of cosets that can be discussed with some example problems. Okay, first of all, what is coset? Let G comma star is a group. Here star is a binary operation. This binary operation star can be performed on the elements of G. The binary operation star is said to be a group if and only if it satisfies four properties. One is closure, second one is associative, third one is identity, fourth one is inverse. So whenever the binary operation star satisfies these four properties on the elements of G, hence we can say that G comma star is a group. Okay. Now small a is an element of G that can be represented as A belongs to G. Next, H comma star is a subgroup of G comma star. Here H is a finite set. It contains finite number of elements, that is set of P comma Q comma R comma S. The binary operation star satisfies the above mentioned four properties such as closure, associative, identity and inverse properties on the elements of H. Hence we can say that H comma star is a subgroup of G comma star. So this is the graphical representation. H is a subgroup of G. Hence we can say that H subset equal to G. Okay. Now here small a is an element of G. This small a is combined with all the elements of H, then we can form a coset that is AH. Okay, AH is equal to, okay, so A is combined with P, then we are getting AP. A is combined with Q, we are getting AQ. A is combined with R, we are getting AR. A is combined with S, we are getting AS. Okay, next, second one is every element of subgroup H is combined with all the elements of G, then we are getting a set HA. Okay, so here P is combined with A, then we are getting PA. Q is combined with A, we are getting QA. R is combined with A, then we are getting RA. S is combined with A, we are getting SA. Okay. The first one is called as left coset. Left coset. The second one is called as right coset. Okay. Here we have to form the coset by combining every element of G with all the elements of H, then we are getting a coset AH is equal to set of AP, AQ, AR, AS. Okay, here an element A exists at the left hand side of H, then it can be called as a left coset. Okay. Second one is every element in H is combined with an element of G. Then we are getting coset HA is equal to PA, QA, RA, SA. Okay. So here an element A exists on the right hand side of H, then it can be called as a right coset. Okay, in the symbolic form, the left coset, AH is equal to, this can be written as A into H, such that H belongs to capital H. Okay, here this can be written as A into H. Okay, because here the binary operation is star. So this is called as left coset. Okay, an element A is exist on the left hand side of H, then we are getting A into H such that H belongs to capital H, where capital H is a subgroup of G comma star. Okay, then right coset is H into A is equal to H in small h into A, such that small h belongs to capital H. Okay, here an element A is exist on the right hand side of subgroup H, then it can be called as a right coset. Now we have to verify that left coset is equal to right coset or not. A into H is the left coset, H into A is the right coset. So is A into H is equal to H into A? We have to observe that this is A into H, this is H into A. We can take any element. Here AP is there, here PA is there. AP is equal to PA. So both are same? No, because it is a left coset, it is a right coset. Left coset not equal to right coset. Okay, so if the set G comma star is a group, then left coset not equal to right coset, that is A into H not equal to H into A, that is AP not equal to PA. Okay, when we can say that A into H is equal to H into A? If G is abelian group, okay, with respect to the binary operation star, hence we can say that A into H is equal to H into A. When we can say that the given set G is abelian group with respect to the binary operation star. Okay, here I am mentioning four properties, that is closure, associative, identity and inverse properties. In addition to the above four properties, we can also satisfy one more property, that is the commutative property. In the commutative property, A into B is equal to B into A. Okay, suppose G comma star is an abelian group, it satisfies five properties. One is closure, second one is associative, third one is identity, fourth one is inverse, and fifth one is commutative property. So whenever the binary operation star satisfies the commutative property, that is A into B is equal to B into A. Okay, so then we can say that A into H is equal to H into A. That means left coset is equal to right coset. Okay, so that means A into P is equal to P into A, A into Q is equal to Q into A, A into R is equal to R into A, A into S is equal to S into A. Whenever the commutative property is satisfied with respect to the binary operation star by the G. Okay, so hence we can say that A into H is equal to H into A. Okay, now we can go to the definition. Okay, so whatever I am telling here, that is the definition of coset. Here there are two types of cosets. One is left coset and second one is right coset. So whatever I am explaining up to now, then this is the nodes of coset and what is left coset and what is right coset. Let H comma star be a subgroup of a group G comma star, and small a is an element of G, that is A belongs to G, then the set A into H, that can be represented as AH. So an element A is combined with all the elements of subgroup H, then we are forming a coset A into H is equal to A into small h, such that small h belongs to capital H. So here small a is there at left hand side of H, hence we can say that it can be called as a left coset of H in G. Okay, and here every element of H is combined with an element of G. Then we can form a coset, that is H into A is equal to set of H into A, such that H belongs to capital H. Here small a is there on the right hand side of capital H, then it can be called as a right coset. So how we are forming the left coset and right coset, that can be discussed in the previous. Okay, now suppose I am taking another one. Here G comma plus is a group. Okay, here H comma plus is a subgroup of G comma plus, where H can be defined as set of P comma Q comma R comma S. Here small a is an element of G. Okay, now we have to form the coset by combining every element of G with all the elements of H with respect to the binary operation plus. Then plus. So that is A plus H is equal to, so A plus P comma A plus Q comma A plus R comma A plus S. Okay, so here small a is exist on the left hand side of H, hence we can say that this is called as left coset. Okay, then what is right coset? Every element of H is combined with an element of G, that is A. So then we are getting a coset called H plus A, so is equal to set of P is combined with A, then we are getting P plus A. Q is combined with A, then we are getting Q plus A. R is combined with A, then we are getting R plus A. S is combined with A, then we are getting S plus A. Okay, here A small a is exist on the right hand side of H, so then we can say that this is called as right coset. Okay, so A plus H is equal to H plus A. Is it true? No, it is false. A plus H not equal to H plus A, because A plus P is equal to P plus A. No, A plus P not equal to P plus A. Okay, so that means left coset is not equal to right coset. So when we can say that it is true? If G is abelian group, if G is abelian group with respect to the operation plus. So whenever G is an abelian group, it satisfies another property, that is commutative property. In the case of commutative property, A into B is equal to B into A. So whenever the commutative property is satisfied with respect to the binary operation plus, Then left coset is equal to right coset. A plus H is equal to H plus A. Okay. So whatever I am discussing here, this is the nodes. So H comma plus is a subgroup of G comma plus, and small a is an element of G. Then the cosets of H in G are, so this is the left coset. So A plus H is equal to A plus H, such that H belongs to G, capital H. So small a is exist on the left hand side of capital H, then it can be called as left coset. So H plus A is equal to H plus A, such that H belongs to capital H. Small a is exist on the right hand side of H, then it can be called as a right coset. So if G is an abelian group, so then AH is equal to HA with respect to the binary operation star. A plus H is equal to H plus A with respect to the binary operation plus. Okay, so this is the definition of a coset with respect to the binary operation star and with respect to the binary operation plus. Okay. We are already observed that if G is an abelian group, hence we can say that A into H is equal to H into A with respect to the binary operation star. Okay, so that is the first important property. Next, we can go to the second important property. Okay, let G comma star is a group. E is an element of G. Now H comma star is a subgroup of G comma star, where H can be defined as set of P comma Q comma R comma S. Okay. Now we are forming the left coset by combining an element E with all the elements of H. Then we are forming a coset as E into H. Okay, E into H is equal to, so E is combined with P, then we are getting EP. E is combined with Q, then we are getting EQ. E is combined with R, we are getting ER. E is combined with S, we are getting ES. Okay, EP is nothing but E into P. EQ is nothing but E into Q. ER is nothing but E into R. ES is nothing but E into S. Okay. In the case of the binary operation star, the identity element E is equal to 1. Okay. So that means 1 into P is nothing but P. 1 into Q is nothing but Q. 1 into R is nothing but R. 1 into S is nothing but S, so that is equal to H. E into H is equal to capital H. Okay, because the identity element with respect to the binary operation star is a 1. Substitute 1 value in the place of E, then we are getting P comma Q comma R comma S, that is equal to H. Next one, we are forming the right coset by combining every element in H with the element of E in G. So then we are getting H into E is equal to P is combined with E, then we are getting P into E, that is PE. Q is combined with E, then we are getting Q into E, that is QE. R is combined with E, then we are getting R into E, that is RE. S is combined with E, then we are getting SE, that is S into E is nothing but SE. So here E is equal to 1. We already know that with respect to the binary operation star, identity element is equal to 1. Then we are getting, so P into 1, that is equal to P. Q into 1, that is equal to Q. R into 1, that is equal to R. S into 1, that is equal to S. Then we are getting H. So therefore, E into H is equal to H into E. So that is equal to H. So this is one more another important property. Okay. So with respect to the identity element, the left coset is equal to right coset is equal to H. So this is the second important property. The third important property is AH subset equal to HA subset equal to G. Okay, left coset subset equal to right coset subset equal to G. Next property is order of subgroup is equal to order of left coset. Okay, so here order of subgroup, that means order of H is equal to order of left coset for a right coset. So that is order of AH or HE. So this is left coset, this is a right coset. So order of H means how many number of elements are there in subgroup H, that is equal to 4. Okay, order of AH is nothing but, E into P is nothing but EP, E into Q is nothing but EQ, E into R is nothing but ER, E into S is nothing but ES. Okay, so this is the left coset. So what is right coset? That is P into E, that is PE, Q into E, that is nothing but QE, R into E, that is nothing but RE, S into E, that is nothing but SE. Okay, so how many number of elements are there in left coset? 4. How many number of elements are there in right coset? 4. So that is order of left coset or right coset is equal to 4. So therefore, we can say that order of subgroup is equal to order of left coset over a right coset. But, so order of subgroup not equal to order of G. Okay, order of subgroup is nothing but how many number of elements are there in subgroup? H, 4. How many number of elements are there in G? Only 1. So 4 not equal to 1. We can say that order of subgroup is not equal to the order of group, but order of subgroup is equal to the order of left coset or a right coset. So this is another important property. So whatever I am discussing the properties that can be mentioned here, the last property is a subgroup H itself is a left as well as right coset of H in G. That means a subgroup H is itself a left coset or a right coset of H in G. Okay, suppose I am taking a subgroup H. Okay, left coset for that subgroup is also a H. Right coset for a subgroup H is also a H in G. So this is one more important property. So this is the description about what is coset, what is left coset, what is right coset, what are the properties of cosets. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please share this video to your friends and classmates. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel link. So Divvela Srinivasa Rao.